Welcome back to my channel, it's Dana Diaz. Today is Armistice Day, and if you don't know what Armistice Day, I'm gonna let Siri tell you. Hey Siri, what is Armistice Day?
Armistice Day is commemorated every year on the 11th of November to mark the armistice signed between the Allies of World War I and Germany at Compiègne, France, at 5:45 a.m. for the cessation of hostilities on the Western Front of World War I. Which took effect at 11 in the morning, the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month of 1918. Would you like to hear more?
No, you're right.
But, according to Thomas L. Galbrook, an intelligence officer with the U.S. 1st...
Hey, Siri!
...shelling from both sides continued for the...
Hey, Siri!
...ending early at nightfall...
Siri!
Stop!
And I have to be at the memorial for 10 past 10. And it is... Hey Siri, what's the time?
It's 9:51.
I need to go like right now. I put my name down to go to Armistice Day and be representing the squadron at the memorial. So I need to get changed like right now and go. Yeah. So get ready with me into Wedgwood Blues. So what it consists of is a light blue shirt, skirt, barely black tights, and a jumper with my brassard and the beret with a tie as well. That is Wedgwood Blues. I'm gonna get changed into it right now. Now, as you can see, I got the skirt and the shirt on. As you can see, this shirt is not ironed, so I have to do a Windsor knot, but I already have it done because I'm like really good at preparation and stuff. That's why I'm cutting it so fine today. It should be uncomfortable because that's how they want us to dress. Perfect. Pain is beauty. Flip that down. God, blimey, I haven't worn this in forever. So I have my jumper here. I'm gonna put my rank slides on it because I'm a sergeant now, so my sergeant rank slides. Like so, up there. Side one, on there. Hold on, which side does the brass look? I think it's the right side. I'm wrong because I have not worn my uniform in so long, I don't remember. This is me, brassard. I'm not gonna show you what's on it because I'm embarrassed. And there might be fellow cadets watching this. I can't remember if it's the right arm or the left arm. We'll just have to see when I show my. When I rock up there, they're like, you idiot. I'm gonna do my hair now. Okay, I couldn't find a single donut in the flipping house. And I need a donut. But we're gonna freewheel it today and brush it out. I'm gonna put it in a low bun at the back. Not supposed to have wispy bits on the side or at the back. I'm just gonna make it into a bun. And I need a hairnet to put on it. Just twist it around. And then hairspray any wispy bits. I can't breathe. Oh my god, I hate hairspray. Voila! Thank you. I gotta go. Yeah. I'm back from doing the memorial, and yeah, I was rushing a bit because I didn't want to be late, but I wasn't late in the end, so that's great. I feel like this isn't good lighting, and now since it is Thursday, I have to go to cadets again at 7 o'clock because my cadets runs on a Monday and a Thursday, and it's Thursday today. And guess what the uniform is? Wedgwood's. So I've got two options: change out my clothes now, and it's 1:30, and then get back changed again in 5 hours, or just stay in the clothes. Do you know what I think I'm gonna do? I think I am gonna take off the clothes because it's so uncomfortable. It's so uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I need to shine my shoes a little bit more, and then go to cadets later on today. I don't know why I'm saying it like that. I love going to cadets, but it's just, I have to walk. but I look super smart and style like that. Like, I haven't worn this in 2 whole years and it still fits me perfectly. That is saying something about my my body's growing abilities. Hashtag stop growing at 16. I stopped growing at 16. I got this uniform at 16. I got this uniform at 16. I have not grown out of it one bit. And when we went to cadets, right, this year, when we started to go back to cadets, everybody else looked different. Everybody else looked different, grown up, everything nice. I stayed the same. I stayed the same. Everybody's growing like towers. Not saying I want to be tower, but people have changed and I'm stationary. That's not a bad thing, but it's actually, you know, opened my eyes, you know, I've actually stopped growing. We had to give all of the cadets bigger uniform. I helped with that because it don't fit them no more. I didn't need any uniform. Yeah, yeah, sergeant, yeah. Went back into my pajamas because I can't be asked. I cannot be asked not to be comfortable. So I guess I'll see you at 6 o'clock. Oh, hold on. It's a bit of Let me get it. Let me get it for you. Let me get it. That's better. Oh, it's 5:51. Time to go back to the cadets. I just had a little bit of a lounge about. Ate some food, did some work, did some other stuff, some laundry and stuff, all boring stuff. And then now it's time to go back to cadets. So I'm gonna put my uniform back on. Oh, I found my flipping donut this time. This morning I couldn't find the bloody thing. It was on the floor down there. And I looked down there this morning and I couldn't see it. And when I came back, guess where it was? Down there. I missed it. Like, my mind just erased it. I'm not daring now. I need to put my donut in. My donut. My donut. Donut. My donut. So, yeah. Okay. Well, let's get changed. Yeah. We're doing this again. Yeah. Now it's time for hair. Now I can't really talk to you the first time I was doing this, so I'm gonna talk to you now. I can't breathe. That's why I don't like Wedgwood's, because it's very suffocating, extremely suffocating, but it is the smarter one. That's why I like it at the same time. So I'm just gonna like just oil up my scalp. Yeah, so it's not dry or anything. And just put some oil in my hair because my hair loves it so much. This is a black Jamaican black castor oil. I just put anything. I'm just putting this because it sprays. My other oils don't spray. I'm gonna put my hair in a low bun again. This time with the donut. So remember, it's Sunday's coming up. That means a lot. I think it's all squadrons are gonna do their memorial march, annual march that we do in, it depends what wing you're in. If you're in London wing, you'll march through London. Well, depends actually. Let me backtrack. Royal Air Force Cadets, we have different categories in terms of location. So, and we call them wings. So there's Surrey wing, Kent wing, Middlesex wing. Anybody who's watching this is really, if I get this wrong on camera, in 4K, do you get it? Okay. There's 6 of them. Kent, Surrey, Sussex, Essex, and London. And Middlesex, I think. I think that's correct. If that is wrong, and you go to my cadets, that you didn't hear anything, all right? You be quiet, please. Thank you. I'm tired. I'm gonna go sleep. I'm so tired. And before I go, oh wait, watch the magic happen. Watch this magic happen. Watch the magic happen. And voila, I have me a bun. Because my hair's straightened, hairspray will work. My hair wasn't straight, I would have to use gel, wax, all the glue, glop, 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 and put it in my hair. My hair in its natural state don't like to listen to nobody, just like myself. So it's very on brand, love it. Very put together. On the other side. I can't breathe. So toxic. So that's my hair done, I think. Yep, that's my hair done. All right, for 20 minutes, I'm gonna put another layer on my shoes, because in the Air Cadets, we have to polish our shoes to be spickish, spanish, shiny, maniny, maliny, maguiny, in the spotlight, in the everything. It has to be like the light of the room. That's what your shoe has to be. It has to embody light, you know? What I mean, like it actually is the flashlight on your shoe. That's what it has to be. And so I'm going to put another layer on that before we go. So I'm gonna do that. And I have my little box of thingamajigs here. I have my box of my shoe shine equipment. What I do nowadays, well, I just started doing this yesterday, where I thought, you know what, let me put on some gloves because I don't want my hands to go pink and purple like it did all the thousand times I did my shoes before. Obviously the polish is going to get on your hands when you're polishing your shoes, so I started wearing gloves only yesterday. Do you know what? I haven't got any polish on my hands. See all this? That would have gone on my hands. We don't want that. Coronavirus. And this is the polish that we use. Kiwi. You know what? Let me take the price off of it. I cannot take the price. Yeah, it's a bit pricey. $2.99. Kiwi shoe polish. Not parade gloss. If you get parade gloss, you're going to mess up your shoes. So don't use parade gloss. To all my fellow cadets out there, don't do it. Make sure you got the black, Karzarna, because that's the one, you know, because it's very straightforward. But even though it's very straightforward, I did, for a quarter of my cadet career, I did put brown on my shoes, and I did not notice it was brown. I did not notice it was brown shoe polish because it looks black. I thought, oh, it's black, but I didn't read it for like a long time, and it was all over my shoes. But there's like a theory where if you put a layer of brown underneath the black one, then it gets shinier or something like that. But I don't know if that's true. It's like a theory, like a cadet old wives tale, you know, kind of one of those things. So I don't want to get it on me, so I'm going to use the lid of my shoebox, and put it on my lap. And this is what I do. So I'm gonna give you a little tutorial. Oh, this is fun. I'm gonna give you a little tutorial. I'll probably direct all my cadets to this video as well. This is just the way I do it, so don't shoot me if you don't like it. It's not my problem, because actually everybody has their own ways of doing it. I have my little cup of water here. Look at me, all like prepared, like Mr. Maker. I'm going to take out the finished product now. I'm joking. Right, now that cup of water is completely cold. No heat in it whatsoever, but it's okay because we're not using it for heat. We're just using it to moisten up the polish inside here. Just gonna rub it in like so. Yeah, get it really coated, really, really a lot of it like on there. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna, in circles, just go like this. Onto the shoe, like so. All over, all under. Get in there. Yeah. And we're gonna put the thickest layer we can on it. So yeah, that's what I do. I was doing this all last night, and these were completely matted shoes. Now look at them. Yes, if I do say so myself, I'm very good at shoe polishing. I'm only gonna put it on the front and on the side because I have no time to do the rest of the shoe. Get some more. It's just a very repetitive process, this. And then what do we do? He puts it on the shoe. Bars, put me in the booth right now. Put me in the booth right now, bars. I'll be right back, just like Mr. Maker. Right, so I've put the polish on both of the shoes. As you can see, it's very matte compared to the sides. Yeah, so right now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave it to dry for a bit. And when it's dry, What you do is then when it's dry, what you do is you get a clean piece of cotton wool and you need lukewarm / hot water on that cotton wool, and you need to shine it off. Well, not shine it off, or it will release the shine from the polish. Now, there's myths saying in air cadets that it doesn't matter if you use hot or cold water, it's still gonna shine, blah, blah, but no, that's where you're wrong. And this is what I'm gonna tell you is prophecy. I've got to tell you prophecy, a cadet prophecy right now. It matters. The temperature matters. The temperature of the water matters, my darling. It does. I'm sorry, dear burst your bubble, but it does, okay? What you do is you just keep layering and layering and layering. You don't shine it off. You just keep layering it so it's matte like so. And then what you do is you get some lukewarm or hot water and you put it on a cotton wool and you shine it off. The reason why you need hot or lukewarm water-ish is because it warms up the wax. Do you get it? Science. It warms up the wax, the polish, gets it moving, and it releases the shine exponentially, quickly. I'm just gonna wait for that to like settle. It can settle for like 5 minutes. And then I'm gonna go to the bathroom and shine it off with the hot water tap running, and I'm just gonna mew, 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 mew. All right, so I have gone to the bathroom and washed it off with some lukewarm hot water. And this is the result. Oh my god, I don't know how to do this, man. But you can see that shine here. There you go, the shine. But it's got some water drops on it, water drops. So I'm gonna blow it. Cause I don't want water marks on my shoes. And they are ready to wear. All right, so I'm gonna put these on and go straight over to cadets. Thank you guys for watching yet another of my videos. I hope you guys are doing well and you're staying safe and you're living your best lives, even during this very tough COVID season time. It will pass. So I'm gonna leave you with these words that I thought of recently and I was like, wow, damn, this is such a good quote. So quote me on this. Planning is like a gift to your future self. And everyone likes presents, so give yourself that present and plan your life and stuff. I say that, yeah, I'm late. Yeah, I already am. Wow. If you want to see more videos like this, please click the subscribe button, press the like button if you liked it, and leave a comment down below of what you want to see from me. And that is Dana Dudas out. Bye, friends. Oh my gosh, get on my foot, bro. Okay. What was the transition I did? Oh, it was this one. Let me sing for you while this dries. Ready? Oh, let me try again. As the autumn some much I'm in my pajamas now. Bring back what once was mine. What once was mine.